Hello you guys, how are you today? I hope you're keeping well and keeping safe and keeping the mood up. Not easy, but we've got to all do it. We're all in this together. We are. So I'm just not loving the hair just now. Can't get the roots done. Missing the hairdresser. I'm missing the hairdresser. I am. But we all are out there. Anyway, today I'm Joan, by the way, the skin guru. It'd be really cool if you subscribe to me and hit the notification button. That would be even better as well. So today I want to talk about the skin issue that's called sebaceous hyperplasia. What a name that is. And my own journey with it, right? So if you've had or if you've got a combination of oily skin, that's the skin type that's prone to this issue. And as you reach middle age, you know, in your 40s, and it happened to me where I got these little bumps on the skin. They look like little bumps, but what it is the sebaceous gland, you know, the sebaceous glands attached to the hair follicle or the pore, the sebaceous glands attached to it, but it becomes blocked or clogged with overproduction of sebum, right, and damaged. And this absolutely results in this little bump in the skin. And you know what, I'm trying to think how to describe it, but it looks like a little tiny donut. Yes, it does. There's an indent in the middle, but the rim is usually white or yellowish. Mm-hmm. And you can see it on, you know, especially when you look at middle-aged people, they are prone to it on their foreheads. And I had it here, but under the eye area, on the cheek area, is where you notice it. You can get it on other parts of the body, but you should be able to recognize this once you look for it. So you can get them in little clusters. The little bumps can be in clusters or they can just be on their own. But don't be confused with milia, which is white, a white head. You know, it's not a white head. And I did think that mine were white heads until I went to the dermatologist and I got the confirmed that it was actually sebaceous hyperplasia. Mm-hmm. So what actually is the cause of sebaceous hyperplasia? The sun, you know, I'm always going to nag you about the sun, but you know, I'm going to really tell you something that I don't like admitting. I don't like admitting this, but I was a sun worshipper in the 80s, you know, and I know a lot of you out there will be thinking the same, but really I was that person, and it just isn't good because the sun does damage your skin. You're not aware of it always at the time, and it can show up later, which it did in my own case. Mm-hmm. So the sun is the culprit again for getting this and making this damage happen to the sebaceous glands just by chucking out more oil on your face. And really, this is the overproduction of sebum in that gland. So my own personal experience was that I did have a few lumps here, and I thought, oh, it is milia, and got them treated like milia. In fact, what we did was this treatment. It's, you know, it's called shortwave diathermy, but a tiny needle was then heated up and put into the actual lump, and it didn't heal up. And after a couple of treatments, I thought, no, something's not right about this. This isn't milia, because it just wasn't healing up. And this is a bad thing. When I went to find out about it, and I said, is this sebaceous hyperplasia that I've got here? But this one in here, it just won't heal up. It turned out that in my own case, it was basal cell carcinoma, a form of skin cancer. Mm-hmm. So you can imagine my shock at that, thinking, was it a milia, then realising it wasn't a milia, then getting it checked, because I thought, this isn't right. Is it sebaceous hyperplasia I've got, but why is it not healing? And it was. So really get these things checked out. If you see any of these, an unusual little bump on your skin, it's really important that you do that. So if you've got sebaceous hyperplasia, how do you get rid of it? Well, the number one thing I'm always going to shout about is sunscreen. Yeah, you have to put the sunscreen on to stop this UV damage to your skin. It is a must. Sunscreen every single day, even in the winter, apply it. That is absolutely number one thing I'm going to say. The next thing I want you to look for is an ingredient that's, you know, a cleanser with salicylic acid in it. Okay, salicylic acid is this beta hydroxy acid that is absolutely, apart from shedding the dead skin off your face and make your skin smoother, it's going to clean out the pores and prevent them from blocking up. So salicylic acid as an ingredient, and you can get cleansers. I'm going to put a list of little products down below that I will recommend, but I need you to know about the ingredients that are going to help this skin condition, sebaceous hyperplasia. So retinol is the next thing I would say to you to look at. So retinol delivers vitamin A to the skin, and this is a very, very clever ingredient, retinol, because retinol actually normalizes the oil production. Apart from that, retinol can actually communicate to the skin cells and get them to act in a normal fashion to stop them, you know, going out of shape and putting them back into the normal, a normal cell function. So retinol is really an absolutely great thing if you've got this oily combination type skin and you see these little bumps. Try the retinol at night and build up use of it. Remember, retinol, use it carefully, build up use, and that is really a great thing to do. The last thing I want to tell you about is niacinamide, vitamin B3. Oh, I always have problems saying niacinamide, vitamin B3. Okay, looking for that in as an ingredient, and you can get that in serums, and looking specifically for that, because that's a great cell communicating ingredient that actually does also help control the oil production in the skin. So the treatments, if you went to a dermatologist, they're going to recommend maybe a couple of treatments. There's intense pulse light skin rejuvenation, where a gel is applied to the face, and the skin rejuvenation handle, or this, it's like a block that's put onto your face. Well, the gel's put on, and then this block is put against it, and it flashes light onto your face, and the light penetrates the skin and it cauterizes. And it really repairs the skin. So skin rejuvenation is really good, but that would be a course of treatments. Also, you've got laser evaporation, and a lot of dermatologists would maybe prefer that. That's a shorter treatment and it works. I have to say, what I don't want you to do is scrub your skin, because you see these little bumps. Don't go all hell for leather scrubbing your skin. I'm really against that anyway. But when you've got little bumps in your skin, it's a tendency we've got, haven't we? Here in UK, we want to get rid of it. We get stuck in. No scrubbing, because that will cause, even that can really dry your skin out, cause irritation, and definitely don't go there. So I will list products below that I want you to have a think about. Okay. And remember, if you've got any questions about your skin, you just need to put it in the comments and ask me anything, and I'll try and fix any of your skin issues. Please have a great week and look after yourselves. Bye. Bye.